Today, basically, we have Mr. Justin, who is a very renowned director and associated with the film Green Park. I've read basically very illuminating reviews about the Green Park on the net, you know, on the website, and there's a special website for it as well. Could you please elaborate us on that project?
So the Green Park is a film about the Jewish community in Britain, but not the way you normally expect to see it. So it's not about the Holocaust. It's about what happened to them after the Holocaust.
Around 1950, somewhere in Hempstead area.
That's right. So in the 1940s, a little hotel was set up called the Green Park in the English Riviera in Bournemouth, which is a really strange and an odd place for the English people. And they set up this hotel to give the Jews a place to recover from the war. And I got given this project by a producer whose family had run this hotel, and she had a few photographs and a few stories, and she'd spent 10 or 12 years working on this, and but it was in no way complete. And I've been making documentaries and dramas for many, many years, and I decided that I loved this person and I wanted to help her. And so I and some friends of mine pulled together the material, and we got a lot more material, and we ended up making a film. And I saw it today for the first time in a little while, and I have to say, it's really quite funny. It's funny, and it's soulful, and it's political, and it's about something, and it's all good things that a documentary should be.
Right. What message, Justin, you wanted to spread with the help of this film?
Well, the message is, I suppose, not inconsistent with the Angel Awards message of peace and goodwill to all men and women. It is that immigration makes a country stronger. That when you absorb other people from another culture, whilst initially they may look strange, different coloured, speak different languages, have different customs, and eat different food. Within one generation, they're all supporting Manchester United. They're all fully integrated. They're working hard. They're paying taxes. They are massive net contributors to the economy. Therefore, Brexit, right now, which we hope will go well, is not looking like such a clever idea. Broadly speaking, immigration is a good thing, and tolerance of others in any given society is a good thing.
If somebody wanted to be next, highly successful, thoughtful director like yourself, what do they really need to do for it?
If they want to be the next me?
Like you.
Well, I think that you need to try and think through your ideas. I was lucky to become a filmmaker because I come from a fairly privileged English background.
That's right.
And I have used it quite wisely, but I did have that privilege. I always really admire the people who make films that have got very little. I think I met a couple of Canadians today who made a film that it looked to me like they had really, really scratched it together. And, you know, they're the people I take my hats off to. So they're not the next me. They're better than me.
And if Justin was not a filmmaker or director, what he would have been?
Well, I'm actually thinking now of taking my PhD quite late in life. I'm thinking of becoming an academic, and I'm thinking of teaching others. And I'm thinking of passing on some of the little knowledge that I have about both film and about history to others. I'm at that time of life where I simply don't want to carry on doing things just for myself.
Right. And what would you like to say about Angel Film Awards? What are your views about it?
Well, I think the Angel Film Awards are, they have a very good, wholesome basis, which is, as we know, the basis of peace. But broadly speaking, I think that since I've been here in Monaco, And since I've met a variety of very different people, I have hugely grown myself by the virtue of meeting other interesting people. And frankly, that's the best you can say about any given film festival. Sometimes you go and you just don't get heard. There's just so much noise, there's so many people competing for space. Here, you do get heard. And I have got to meet other filmmakers. There's the Canadian filmmaker I was talking about earlier. He's really good. I'm really impressed.
Filmmaking is such a competitive industry. I think there are always ups and downs. How do you keep motivating yourself?
Well, I think that the problem with surviving in this industry is that you've got to be good enough and successful enough that people will keep on giving you money. I've been able to do that for 25 years, and there's no guarantee that it will carry on happening. So therefore, the motivation is, well, if I don't get more money, then I'll try and make films for less. I will carry on making films the rest of my life. Not all films need money. This Green Park is an inexpensive film. It's very raw. But you know, funnily enough, I made a film last year that was really, really expensive, and it didn't have half the heart of this one. So there's your answer, which is that you can make a film for £100, and if it's got heart, it'll be a good film.